take me back right to the start. Before this ache I feel apart. Closer than the air I breathe. I never thought I'd see you leave. Oh, some days you call me in love and I can tell it's real.
So we made it to the top. It was so scary. It was like rock climbing. And now we have to go down and I'm terrified. But it's so pretty. I'm sitting on the edge. We're making our way down. It's so scary. Everything's so slippery. Yeah, it's one of those things that I tell my mom I did them after I do them. So, once I make it out of this alive, I'll let her know that I did this. So
I'm just gonna explain what we did yesterday first, because I never really did that. We hiked Segla, which is a mountain on Senja. It was beautiful once you got to the top, but getting up there and climbing down, it wasn't the best, because it was kind of like rock climbing, just without the gear. So that's kind of how it was, but it was really cool. Today was a good day at school, and here's the thing. So this morning I woke up and I was very sad, and I didn't really know why. I started getting ready for the day and I had a mini breakdown. I didn't have a specific reason to like be sad. I know some days are like that. I know ever since I got here, it's been what, like 2 weeks? It's been an emotional roller coaster, literally. Every day is different. There's some not so good days, but what I kind of realized today was it's all about like your mindset, because I was having a rough morning and then I decided, I was like, no, I don't want today to be a bad day. I was like, I'm just gonna have a good day. So I had my little breakdown and then I was like, nope, that's not happening anymore. So then I had some coffee, I went to school. And then it was a great day. I feel like I have friends now. My classes were all good. I took English, Spanish, and Norwegian all like back to back, which really messed with my brain.
So I'm just gonna do a little update. It's Wednesday and I have not filmed a lot this week. I mean, since like Saturday, I have not filmed a lot at all. I've been sick since Monday. I've just been sick, like I don't feel good at all. Yesterday was pretty bad. Today my head has been like pounding all day. I haven't done much since Sunday because I just haven't felt very good and I just want to get better fast. So basically in Norway they have this thing called rus, I think that's how you say it, and basically it's the third year kids, basically the seniors of the high school, and they just like party. They wear like the same outfits. I don't really know that much about it, but they're big on like parties and stuff. And so basically the kickoff party for this year's rus is Saturday. It's something that like everyone goes to. And so basically I was gonna go with some friends. They sell the tickets at like each school in the area. I think like one day they sell the tickets, and so yesterday they sold the tickets at our school and they didn't tell anyone where they were selling them, so everyone was just running everywhere. I didn't realize how big of a deal this was, but everyone was just running like around the school trying to find where they were selling the tickets, and there was just like so many people. And basically we found it, and then it was in a little hallway and everyone was just like crammed in, like trying to get into this room, and they were like selecting people to like come in, and then just like the front people then got it. And so I didn't get a ticket, and they made it a rule where at the schools they're selling them at later this week, they can only buy one ticket. So we can't really get tickets now anymore, which kind of sucks. I just thought it would be cool for like the experience. So that's that. It was chaotic. I didn't know it was that big of a deal, but I guess every year it's a big deal here in Norway. But today, something that they did that was like really cool, I think we should be doing something like this in the US. It was all dedicated to this like debate, and basically they had someone representing each party, each political party, because there's a big election coming up here in Norway, and they had somebody representing each party, and then they had a debate in front of all the kids, and then they had like all their booths set up. We could go around and like talk to each of the representatives and all that stuff. And then they had everyone go and like vote on what they would choose if they could actually vote in like the election that's very soon. And I think it's really cool because it keeps the kids educated on everything that's going on. Everyone that I talked to like knew a lot about politics, which I think is really impressive because that's not always the case at home. So another thing that I was trying to talk about, but I've already kind of learned, is I always have this kind of mindset, but it's something my mom always told me to do. Don't look at the negatives, look at the positive things that can come from the negatives. There's nothing like negative going on, but just little things, just like day-to-day things that I'm like, oh, I miss this. What I've like realized more is there's always a better side to what you're thinking about. So like me, I'm like, oh dang, I really miss this at home, or I'm really sad I'm missing out on this. I think about there's something way cooler that I can experience here. I'm only here 1 year of my entire life. Start every day with just the mindset that there's always something positive coming from something negative you're thinking. There's always something better. I'm learning a lot. I feel like this year, it's barely started. I'm like, 2 weeks into the year? 3 weeks ago today, I left home. And already, I'm starting to like see these little things. A positive mindset really goes a long way. Like, you don't think that when you're like, okay, you can't just think happy thoughts and happy things will happen. But if you look at something negatively, if you're like, dang, I have to do this, then you're gonna not enjoy it. But if you look at something and you're like, I get to do this, then you're gonna enjoy it. So like little things like that is like already what I've been realizing. So it's Thursday. I'm still sick. It's better than it was yesterday. My head doesn't hurt as bad. I'm hoping I can like get rid of this sickness soon. Today was a pretty good day at school. I was really tired like at the end of the day because I feel like our days are just so long. Like they go until 3:30. Tomorrow we have Naturfag all day, maybe like earth science or something, I think, like nature basically, Naturfag. So basically what we're doing is we're going like out into the woods and we're like looking for species and like certain plants and stuff. We're gonna spend a few hours out there, and it's supposed to be really cold and rainy. Today is really cold, but it's not rainy. Tomorrow's supposed to be colder and rainy, so it should be fun. But yeah, then after school I'm going down to Finnsnes with some other girls. We're gonna go to the little shopping center that they have here, like mall, and we're gonna hang out. And yeah, that should be fun.
Hey. Hey.
So now we're out on a trip. It's called a fog dog, and we have what do you call it in English?
Subject.
So we're out looking at plants.
You gonna say hi?
Gonna say hi.
Hello.
We are also the first phase. This.
Hello. So now we eat is. Men, egg, mat. For jeg har spist taco, så
er jeg ikke
sikker.
Ja. Jeg har valgt Oreo og brownies, og de er veldig, veldig gode.
Ja.
Jeg tok det basic-e. Cookie dough, Oreo.
Og jeg og Alison har det samme,
ja,
som er cookie dough og sjokolade brownie.
Ja.
Så jeg skal bare gjøre en liten overview av hva vi gjorde i dag. So today was a really fun day, actually. It's been raining pretty much all day, quite a bit. It's very cold and wet outside. So at school, we had Naturfag all day. So basically what we did was we went on a little tour. It's basically like a trip or a hike or something. That's what they call it. So that's what we did. We walked like 30, 45 minutes out into the forest. And then there was like a little like tent and then like some random like benches and like places you could sit under to like not be in the rain. And we just ate some food. And then we walked back and we were all like soaking wet because it was raining the whole time we were out there. And it was very cold, but I got some new clothes yesterday. I got some new shoes. They're not the cutest, but they do the job. They're waterproof. They're like hiking shoes, so I won't like slip around. Some like waterproof pants, once again, not the cutest, but they do the job. Not the cutest outfit in the world, but it kept me dry, so that's good. Then we went to Finnsnes, and I changed into some dry clothes, which felt so good. One of my friends, Julia, her phone like broke. It was like spazzing out and then it just shut off. So we had to go to the phone store. One thing that's really cool is Finnsnes is just like such a small town and so everything is there. So we were like at the mall and then they'd like go to the bank for something and then like the phone store and then another grocery store and then like you can just go everywhere so easily. We went to a little like sandwich type of place in the mall and I was told to try the taco wrap because that's like taco is very, very popular here in Norway. It's like one of their most popular things to eat. So yeah, that was good. But yeah, you wouldn't think, like I had no idea coming here that taco was very popular, but it really is. And then we got some ice cream. We kind of just shopped around a little bit. So yeah, it was fun. I was requested to put some Norwegian into my video. So I put that little clip in there of everyone like talking about the ice cream. I've been feeling a lot more comfortable like understanding Norwegian. I've definitely already learned a lot. If somebody talks slow, I can most likely understand everything they say, which is pretty good. I'm surprised with myself. It's still hard for me to respond. Sometimes I can only do like simple sentences, but I can understand most of what people say, which is good. So I'm working on that still.
In Norwegian.
En som veldig stygg, så det ananas på.
Nei, det kan ananas
veldig bra. Alle her elsker ananas, men hun gjør ikke det.
Ja.
Hun liker ikke ananas.
Ja.
We are bubbling.
Yeah, bubbling.
Yeah.
Are you like doing...
Okay. And now we are bubbling and we are having so much fun and we love Alison already.
Yeah.
I'm gonna miss her when she's gone.
Yeah.
Don't worry about that.
Yeah. Oh my god, but I'm winning this shit. That's the important stuff. Oh my god, yeah.
Hello.
Hey, hello.
Hallo!
Så nå vi ferdig på bowlingen.
Yeah.
Så vi skal gå til huset til
Alison.
Yeah, not my house actually.
Yeah, yeah.
We're gonna watch a movie.
Yeah.
I don't know what movie, not a scary one.
Yeah, a comedy, I hope.
Okay, that's it for this week's little vlog, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm gonna start a new one later, and then, yeah.
Yay!
Yay, bye!
Holla!
Subscribe!